Our entire family was raised Muslim, and whereas I had friends that went to church, on the weekend or on Sundays, every weekend we used to go to the Islamic school, Islamic Sunday school, and the mosque at that time. And we learned how to say our prayers 5 times a day in Arabic. We were taught by the instructors how to obey our parents and try to do what was right and, not do what was wrong. Sometimes they would each week record how many of the 35 prayers we did. So it was interesting. We would pray our prayers sometimes at high speeds just to get those points. And I remember that from an early age. Sometimes it was just racing through the prayers in a fairly quick manner. Salawat, as prayers are called in Arabic for Muslims, to get up to 35 prayers a week, because Muslims pray 5 times a day, 7 days a week, and our goal was to get 35 prayers. We continued going to being a part of the mosque for many years, up until the time I became a teenager. And I always maintained a belief in God. I always maintained a belief that there was an eternal power. This was the God, Allah, as we call it in Islam. And I always held a measure to the roots that I was brought up in. Things changed for me when I was about 18 years old. I graduated from high school. I went to college, and I just started to wake up to, okay, well, here I am, a young man now. What should I do with my life? What should I study? What kind of work should I take up? And in that process, I started searching a bit more. I started delving into studying history, philosophy, different religions, politics. I got interested, like many young people do, in all those things. And it just so happened, as I look back on it through the providence of God, I happened to get a hold of a Bible. Now here I was, a young man who was raised a Muslim, who's been taught from a young age that Islam is the true religion, and grew up praying Muslim prayers, and was educated. Any religious education I had came from Muslims. Now starting to consider the Bible and even other religions. And there were times when I thought, well, no, maybe the way of the Muslims is the right way. And then I started thinking, the Christians, they say they have the right way, and Jews, they think they have it. And maybe nobody has the right way. Maybe nobody has the truth. I continued to read the Bible, and I can say one interesting thing. As I was reading the Bible, I continued to remember a prayer that Muslims always pray and say over and over again in their daily prayers, from Surah Fatiha, which says, "Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim, ghayr al-maghdubi alayhim wal-dallin." This Muslim prays many, many times in a day. And "Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim" means show us the straight way. It's a prayer that Muslims pray, and sometimes we would pray these prayers without thinking about it. We might have been thinking about what was for dinner. We might have been thinking about if there was a game to be played or to be watched. But in this time in my life, when I was searching for the way to God, I was searching for the truth, I continued, even in reading the Bible, to pray this prayer, "Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim." God, Allah, show me the straight way. And as I continued to read the Bible, I started to learn something that I never knew before. And that was, I began to discover Jesus Christ as He's revealed in the Bible. You know, the Islamic religion taught me do this, do good, don't do bad, how to live your life. Other religions, even that I was starting to look in, had systems of laws and rules and do's and don'ts. But at that same time, I was waking up to the fact that, well, for example, I had gone to university and I was playing on the soccer team. And I noticed that, every person on the team wanted to be the person that scored the goal. There was self-centeredness, and it was in me. My fellow classmates, they came from all other different parts of the country, and even some from around the world. And everyone was concerned about, I'm going to get that job, I'm going to make that money, I'm going to be rich, I'm going to be successful. And I said, what is this? Everyone is so self-centered. But I saw it in myself too. And I began to despair, because I saw my self-centeredness a sinfulness, as we would call it in religious terms or in Christian terms, and I couldn't escape it. And every religion, including Islam, which was the one I was raised in and knew most about, gave a way or a system of beliefs of how to do right and not do wrong. But it was only Jesus, as described in the Bible, that said, I can give you a new heart. And I read in John chapter 8 where it says, if the Son shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. So it took me a period of several months of reading, of studying the Bible, comparing it with the Islamic beliefs I had, and continuing to pray this prayer, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. And God was revealing to me the way. You know, Muslims, we always pray, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, show us the straight way. And Jesus himself in the Injil, in the Gospel, says, I am the way. And God was slowly revealing to me that this Jesus is the one that can save you from your self-centeredness, from your sinfulness. And I said, Lord, I'm going to give my life to you. More and more, my heart felt warmed because I knew that I was self-centered, I was a sinful person, and only Jesus Christ is saying, I can save you, I can give you a new heart. And that was something I had never heard before. Well, my whole life has been changed. At the time that I was wrestling with those decisions, I thought to myself, maybe I should go in politics because the world is a miserable place. Even a young man can understand that. And maybe I could help change this world. And I'll do what I want to do and what I think I need to do. But when Jesus Christ became the Lord of my life, now my prayer is, Lord, what do you want me to do? How can I serve you, Lord? And I consider it a privilege and a blessing because, in our Islamic religion, much of what we do is dictated to us when to pray, how to pray, how to wash, how to do your wudu, how to obtain the barakat, the blessing, by fasting, by giving, by alms, zakat, salawat, the whole system. But in the Injil, in our Christian faith, Jesus Christ is able to direct us through His Word, and we are not slaves, but we're free people who can choose to serve Him of our own free will. Yes, we do have rules, we do have standards, we do have instruction from the Word of God, but it's not a doing it out of fear that if I don't succeed in this practice, I will have guilt, I will have shame, I will have sins. It's a sense of freedom, it's a sense of wonderful happiness to be a Christian, it's a sense of liberation, and I always am so thankful to the Lord Jesus Christ that He saved me, that He called me, and that He took me to be His disciple. The Bible was the key in my conversion. I believe if Muslims would read the Bible, many of them would become Christians. Even though many Muslims, we know and we're taught that the Bible, according to the Islamic thinking, is not the real Word of God. But many Muslims in reading it will understand that this is a piercing, true Word of God. I'm praying for Muslim people, people that are Muslims, that were Muslims that have become Christians, have a tremendous empathy for Muslims. And I'm praying for Muslims to begin to seek God and to have the courage to consider what they must do. For Muslims, many times, we hide behind the excuse of, well, I was born a Muslim, I was raised a Muslim, I can't leave the Islamic religion, so I have an excuse. But I believe on the Day of Judgment, that excuse will not be satisfactory. People will stand before God on the Day of Judgment, and we're sinners standing before a holy God. We have no atonement, no qurban in our Islamic religion, but we have in the Injil, Jesus Christ dying for us. So I'm praying that Muslims will take the courage, take up the courage to even risk their reputation, their livelihood, their family, whatever it may be, to gain Jesus Christ. And it's a big cost, it's a big cross, but Many, many, many Muslims are now having the availability to hear about the true Christian gospel, and many are in fact responding to it. And I thank God for those brothers and sisters, and I pray for our other Muslims, friends, family, loved ones, that they too will hear this glorious message of Jesus Christ and respond to it. And that they would discover the grace of God. It's not a salvation that we earn by our own good works or strive to by our own dealings, but it's a grace that God has given us through Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, and the life.